this precious little baby into the bathtub and putting him into the water. They're intending to build in the watershed area, and this encroaches very close to the watershed, which is protects the Kensco Reservoir, which supplies drinking water for 9 million people. And Brian, we live right close by, right, Brian? Yeah.
So many women are on methods of birth control that are hormonal. And in order to get a certain level of hormones that's going to keep your body from being fertile involves also passing a lot of hormones through your urine. And that goes, in many cases, straight into surface water or groundwater. And that can cause any number of problems, particularly hermaphroditism in various amphibious species. I think that's probably the quote-unquote canary in the coal mine for that particular issue.
To break apart the shale and get the gas out, they use water at very high pressures, millions of gallons of water.
We're talking 3 to 5 million gallons of water per well, per fracking. And sometimes over the life cycle of these wells, they may frack it 5 to 18 times. And you know, that's one well, and they're talking maybe 10,000 wells in the state.
There is a well that's only a couple hundred feet from her home. It had a blowout, a huge blowout. They can't be done safely when all these toxic chemicals are being put into the water and there's no method for taking them out. It can't be done safely when you're drilling deep underground into geological formations that have toxic chemicals in them, such as arsenic and lead, very heavy concentrations of salt water and other salts, and in the case of the Marcellus Shale, are radioactive. Water is essential to life, and why would we be wasting millions of gallons of this essential resource to produce gas, which, you know, doesn't make sense to me.
What is the best method to stop a development that you don't want? There are some, of course, good websites, always very helpful. And of course, I got to crow about our website, the Croton Watershed Clean Water Coalition. I'm very impartial. It's called newyorkwater.org. NRDC has a good website, Riverkeeper, Sierra Club. Environmental advocates, they all have informative websites. And one of the best ones is fairly recent. It's called ProPublica. And they have a lot of good information. I think you've got to get a lot of grassroots opposition. It's probably the best way you can do it these days. The best way is to affect the politicians is through grassroots action, and particularly near an election year.
If I had one thing that I wanted to see happen this year with regards to water, I think that's like asking what you want for Christmas. I guess conservation, because it's so tied into all of the other issues. People understand how much water they use and what a precious resource it is. That gives them some awareness as far as, you know, where it comes from and what they're contributing to that source. So I suppose it'd be conservation, but I could probably give you three other answers on three other days.